In this GIMP workshop, we're going to create a text portrait with text that is edited in WordCloud. When you want to follow along, you can find the link for the image and for the website WordCloud in the description. Go to File, click Open, search for your image and open it. Click on the zoom icon in the top right to fit the image in the window. Now right-click on the layer and click Add Alpha Channel. When we have an image in color, we now go to the menu bar and click Colors. Now click Desaturate. Here we just click OK. The effect looks best when we have a portrait that's a bit close up. Select the crop tool in the toolbox. Check the option Fixed Aspect Ratio, so when we crop the photo we will keep the same aspect ratio as the original. Now draw out a selection. By click and drag the handles and or the corners we can make adjustments, and when we click and drag inside the framework we can move the whole selection. When it looks okay, we hit Enter or click into framework to confirm. Now go to View, Zoom, and click Fit Image in the window. Go to Colors, click on Brightness and Contrast. Increase the brightness as well as the contrast with 10 by clicking one time on both slider lines. Then click OK. We will add some text that we first will edit in the website WordCloud. There is a link in the description to this free website. Or you can just download the WordCloud text file that I've already made and skip this part of the tutorial. The download link for this text is in the description. When we make and edit our own text, we start by copying the text that we want to use for the image from our hard drive. Select your text. Press Ctrl+C. Then we open WordCloud. First we make the orientations 2. Then we change the angle arrows to 0 and to 90. Go ahead and click in the text, like shown in the video, and hit Ctrl+A to select all this text. Then we press Ctrl+V to paste our own text. Now we can click several times on the Go button until we are satisfied with the composition. Then we can download this text file by clicking on the button Download as VG. Save it somewhere on your hard drive, we will import it into GIMP in a moment. Now we go back to GIMP. Make the scissor select tool active. Make a selection, like shown in the video, where you want the text to come. We can zoom in or out by pressing the Ctrl key and rolling the mouse wheel. When we press and hold the spacebar, cursor changes into the Move tool, and we can, by moving the mouse without clicking, move the whole image. When we let go of the spacebar, we have the eraser tool again. We have made our selection, we place the last note over the first note and click one time. Then we hit Enter to make the selection. Go to View, Zoom, and Fit Image in Window. Now we click on Select and then on Feather. Feather the selection with 10 pixels and click OK. Then we go to Select and click Invert, so the background is selected. Go to Edit and click on Clear, so the background is deleted. Back to Select now and hit None. Go to File, open as Layers, search for your text file and open it. In the dialog box that pops up, we just click OK. Make the portrait layer invisible. The text layer should be active. Go to the menu bar and click on Colors and then on Levels. At the input levels we move the right arrowhead all the way to the left, so we get a white text. Click OK. Now we will add some relief to the text. Click Filters, light and shadow, and then drop shadow. Make the blur radius 0 and click OK. Right click on the text layer and hit merge down, so the text layer and the drop shadow layer become one layer. Double click on the name and change it to text. Hit enter. Go to layer, transform and click rotate 90 degrees counterclockwise. Click 3 times on the duplicate button at the bottom of the layers panel, so we have now 4 text layers. Click the move tool active and check the option move the active layer. Click and drag the top layer to the left top of the image. Then select the layer below this one and move it to the right top. Make sure it still overlaps the other layer. Click in the layers panel the layer below and move it to the left bottom. Click the last text layer and move it to the right bottom corner. Make sure all these layers overlap each other. Right click on one of the layers and hit Merge Visible Layers. Click Merge. Make the text layer invisible and the portrait layer visible. Select the portrait layer. Click the new layer icon at the bottom of the layers panel and choose foreground color as the layer fill type, which should be black. Click OK. Move this layer by click and drag to the bottom of the layers tag. Right click on the portrait layer and hit Add Layer Mask. Leave it at white full opacity and click Add. Now we select the text layer, make it visible, go to Edit and click on Cut. Go back to Edit now and hit Paste. Click on the anchor at the bottom of the layers panel. The text is now pasted in the layer mask of the portrait. With the layer mask still selected, we click on Colors, Curves, and here we can adjust the text to our liking. Click the preview off and on to see the effect, then click OK. Now we activate the eraser tool. We make the size about 50. Zoom into the eyes by holding the control key down and rolling the mouse wheel. Erase a bit of the text in the eyes to make them good visible. Then we go to View, Zoom and Fit Image in Window, and there we have it, a nice text portrait. I hope you have fun with this video, and if that's the case, please give it a like, maybe leave a nice comment, and subscribe if you haven't done already to support my channel. Thank you very much for watching.